So Shannon is one of our secret weapons at Vista, and you'll hear why in a few minutes. But I think one of the things, Shannon, if you wouldn't mind, talk a little bit about how you are leading efforts within Vista to not only understand where GenAI is across our portfolio companies, but how we're going to utilize it internally and what you believe to be the efficacy and opportunity of utilizing in our underwriting process.
Yeah, so the first, as this technology was evolving, and it's, you know, AI has been around for a very long time. Vista has been engaging with AI. Our portfolio companies have been engaging with AI for a very long time. The evolution of these private and open source models poured an incredible amount of jet fuel on that movement very, very quickly. And so as an organization, the first thing that we did, just from a risk management perspective, was focus on our portfolio companies. So where is their risk? Where is their opportunity? We looked at every single company and effectively sort of charted them. Now, the reality is where there's the most opportunity, there's generally the most risk. And so understanding where our companies were in their maturity curve to innovate and act on this technology was an important first step. So once we sort of understood that, the next step was sort of twofold. One was, how do we incorporate this technology into the value that our companies are delivering to their customers? So that's how you stay in front of the innovation curve. That's how you ensure that from a disruption perspective, you're the disruptor and not the disrupted. And so that's been very important, especially for businesses, candidly, in the front office space that are sort of more, you know, sales and marketing focused. We're seeing a lot of disruption there. Call centers, a lot of disruption there. There's some industries that are far more insulated, at least in the medium term. The second pillar of that was, how do we use this to drive efficiency for our organizations and allow them, you know, not just within marketing organizations, but across the whole organization to do, you know, not necessarily more with less, but more with the same. And so a big push there, one of the places we went immediately, was Copilot for our developers. And so, you know, I think the general perspective that we are taking is commercially viable or commercially available products allow you to make progress really quickly. May not be the pieces that unlock the most amount of productivity. Those may take time and more investment and more resources, but there's a lot of things available that you can sort of implement quickly that already have the right levels of security baked into them to actually make progress really quickly. So, you know, our entire portfolio adopted Copilot really within months. We were able to measure and see the impact of that very, very quickly, which then allows our teams to be, you know, more innovative or hopefully as innovative as they can be relative to their competitive set. And so that's really, you know, the focus on the portfolio. And that's a cross-functional effort at Vista. We have folks from legal, compliance, our value creation team, our investment team, technologists, outside folks that we're bringing in as outside experts, because everyone's learning this sort of real time. And I think in those moments, it's incredibly important to have collaborative efforts. And then at the same time, once we sort of had our arms around our portfolio, which is our you know, the crown jewel of Vista, we then looked internally and said, okay, well, how can we drink our own medicine here and actually adopt and enable ourselves in the same way that we've been engaging with our portfolio about how they should be enabling and adopting this solution. And so, you know, I'd say there's a few components of that. One is our underwriting. So how should this change how we identify risks and opportunities and new potential acquisition opportunities? And that comes in the form of, you know, there's certain technology businesses that we probably just won't touch right now. So there's, you know, things like web scraping. That feels like it's getting commoditized in this new environment. But then there's also companies where we feel like there's the opportunity to unlock a new and really interesting value set. And that really, from our perspective, hinges on the data that they have available. And that's not just data in the form that maybe Amy was referencing around, you know, your customers and where they have, you know, their brokerage accounts, but it's also data in terms of the activities that people are doing within your platform. and actually being able to capture that to deliver value back. And so there's some interesting companies that we're evaluating where we think we can actually inflect the growth curve because there's an opportunity to deliver more value to their customers and then capture more of that from a top-line perspective. And so that's really our underwriting, and you know, it's incorporated into our investment committee discussions. It's very top of mind for folks at all levels of the firm. And then there's just the productivity gains. So how can we adopt this technology so that, you know, I can do my job more efficiently, that the analysts and associates who work 120 hours a week can do their jobs more efficiently, or maybe they can get a little bit more sleep, one or the other.
Why are you giving them 120 hours? That's,
so,
they got half duty now, or what?
And again, that's...
Make a note to self.
That's still, I would echo what I said earlier around the sort of crawl, walk, run approach. And so, you know, when we're dealing with public data, so we look at a lot of public companies, I read a lot of earnings transcripts, I read a lot of really boring 10Ks, that's publicly available information. We're gonna treat that and experiment with that very differently than we may the private information that we have access to or some of the proprietary knowledge that Vista has accumulated that's part of our special sauce over 25 years of investing. And so we're trying to approach it where we wanna get this technology in the hands of folks as quickly as possible and drive the most amount of productivity gains, but we wanna do it in a way that's thoughtful around the actual data that you're working with and the outcomes you're trying to drive.